Hey guys, Worlder here. Today, we're going to be doing a different type of tutorial, and that's just going to show you how to upscale some of your images, just in case you're trying to make a little bit of content or make some awesome wallpapers. So this is going to be a 1920x1080 pretty much blank canvas here in GIMP. I want to actually get this image over there, but if we take it over here, you'll see that it's super tiny, and if we try scaling it up at all, it looks normal, right? And it looks really nice and clean, but the moment you click away, it gets really blurry and very unappealing very fast. So let's go ahead and see what we can do. Go ahead and shut that one off real quick, just so we can see what we're doing here. And what I want to do is I want to get this as big as 400. You want to make sure it's within this little box here. Make sure you can see the whole entire picture. You get your snipping tool out, hit new. And what you want to do is you want to click within the picture, but don't get it on the yellow dotted lines, because then you'll have them come out in your crop. So just like that, you'll lose just a little bit of image, but it's fine. It's not a game breaker. And there you go. You have a bigger, much nicer, cleaner, sharper image at a much bigger scale. Then you just save it here wherever you want. Here, I'm going to save it to this upscaled background. So I'm just going to name it... just for the video, go ahead and hit save. Go ahead and come back over here. Come over here, file, in. And then I'm gonna go back to my upscale backgrounds, the upscale PNG that I just made right here, open. And you'll see here that it is way bigger and a way nicer quality than it was before. Let's go ahead and grab this, drag it to our area, and there you go. And just so you can see the difference, it's pretty blurry here. So let's go ahead and stretch this out just a little. Now, it may not be the biggest, but it's still a much less blurrier background, as you see here. The difference. Without it, with it. Without it, with it. Without it, and with it. And there you go. That's a small little trick that I like to use when making my thumbnails for my YouTube videos. I hope this helps somebody out there. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, consider liking, please, and have a good day. Peace.